And Jesus Christ, He is speaking about the Father in heaven. He is your Father and my Father. Again and again, in the Gospel of St. Matthew, if you start taking stock from chapter 1, verse 1, you will come across this phrase, your Father, thy Father, your Father, thy Father, 13 times before the first time He says, my Father. It's an amazing situation. That 13 times the man is telling you that God Almighty is the Father of everybody. Metaphorically, He is the creator, sustainer, evolver, cherisher of everybody. He is the Father of everybody, but physically He does not beget. Because begetting is an animal act. It belongs to the lower animal functions of sex. And we were not to attribute such a quality to God, that God begot a son. Though the Christians keep on repeating the words, Son of God, Son of God, Son of God. So he said, what about Adam? He said, how many sons has he got? The bulk of Christendom will tell you one. I said, you're not reading your Bible. You don't read your Bible properly. You know, God has got sons by the tons in the Bible. By the tons. You know, tons, the old measurement of weighing things. Tons. Genesis chapter 6 verse 3. It says, and the sons of God saw the daughters of men, that they were fair, and they took them to wife all that they chose. And when the sons of God came in unto the daughters of men and bore children to them, they became great men of old men of renown. In the book of Exodus, God says, Israel is my son, even my firstborn. In the book of Jeremiah says, Ephraim is my son, even my firstborn. In the New Testament, we are told, as many as are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God. Every Tom, Dick and Harry, if you follow the will and plan of God, you are a godly person. In the language of the Jew, in the idiom of the Jew, he says, son of God, meaning a righteous person. But the Christian says, no. Jesus is not like that. He's begotten, not made. So I'm asking, please explain to me. I'm asking the English-speaking people. Please explain to me, what are you trying to emphasize? When you tell me He is begotten, not made, what are you really trying to tell me? And believe me, no Christian in 40 years has been able to open his mouth to tell me what it means. It had to be an American, not Brother Sharosh. It had to be an American. He said, it means sired by God. I said, what? He said, no. You ask me what it means. I'm only telling you what it means, not that I believe that God sired a son. So, he says, Jesus Christ. Either now, this to the Muslim is a blasphemy, to say that Jesus is God. But there is another blasphemy from the Christian point of view. You see, the Christian, the Orthodox Christians, the Anglican Christians, the Methodists, and all the Roman Catholics, they all believe in the Holy Trinity, and they say that Jesus is the second person of the Trinity. You never hear the word is in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. You'll never hear in the name of the Holy Ghost and the Son and the Father. Never. You'll never hear in the name of the Son and the Holy Ghost and the Father. It must ever be in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. He is always the second person of the Trinity. If anybody in Christendom says that Jesus is the Father, it is a heresy in the Christian church. From the Muslim point of view, attributing divinity to any created being is blasphemy, kufr. But from the Christian point of view, from the church's point of view, Anglican, Methodist, Lutheran and all, if anybody says, has the temerity to say that Jesus is the Father, it is an ancient heresy which was condemned and extirpated by the Roman Catholic Church over 1,000 years ago. They got rid of it. Where you